Hi, class 5. I hope you have seen the links which I have uploaded, and I have put up a PDF file also today. You just please check those on the download place, the download section of your website, and you'll see a download PDF download for you guys. Please go through that, it will be a lot of help for you. And we were at the imaginary lines, latitude and longitudes, isn't it? There's going to be another video there for you in the Y links and the YouTube links also. In the just when you scroll down, you'll see my lectures. In that only you will see there's another YouTube link which you can go ahead, and there's much explanation there about the longitude and the latitude with the globe. It is shown, so it will be much more easier, which I can't show here. So I'm reading, explaining at the same time. When you watch that video, minutely see it, rewind again, you play back and see it, and see, understand, and write down. It's going to help you a lot. Okay, just learn. Okay, so we were here, and the besides the equator, there are four other important latitudes which we said: Tropic of Cancer 21.5 degrees north, Tropic of Capricorn 23.5 degrees and south, Arctic Circle 66.5 degrees north. And Arctic Circle is 66.5 degrees on the south. Important properties of latitudes. The latitudes are parallel to each other and can therefore never meet. The lines of latitude run in an east-west direction, from the east to the west, because the sun rises in the east and goes down in the west. The equator is the longest latitude. As we move to the north or south of its parallel of latitude, go on decreasing in length and finally reduced to a dot at the poles. I told you, like we are going down, it's like a spherical, and when you are going towards the down part, this is the largest part, and slowly you are going down. So when you are coming here, it comes and joins at the dot at the poles. Longitudes. Besides the latitudes, we see another set of lines that run from north to south on the globe. These are known as meridians of longitude. The word meridian means midday, and hence a meridian of longitude joins places which have midday at the same time. Means it's afternoon, 12 p.m. Not in the night, 12 p.m. in the noon. And 12 a.m. is night. This is the meridian. See. This is the latitudes, round ways, and this is the longitude, which comes straight down. This is a meridian. It makes the part, it joins the parts where the midday is. Meridian is midday, so they join the parts at the same place where they are at the same time. They may be far away, but at that time the time zone is same. The longitude that passes through the observatory at Greenwich near London is the prime or main meridian and is marked as 0 degree. All other longitudes are measured from the prime meridian and are followed by east or west, by E for east and W for west. Always remember, the prime meridian and the 180 degree meridian form a circle which divides the earth into two hemispheres. The part of the earth between 0 degree and 180 degree is called the eastern hemisphere, and while the part from 0 degree 180 degree west is called the western hemisphere. Now we made a half with the latitudes, we are making a half this way also, straight ways. So this side is the eastern and this side is the, sorry, I'm not able to see, this side is the western and this side is the eastern hemisphere of the longitudes. And the main meridian is marked 0, that is Greenwich near London. Greenwich is a place. Where is London? That is when it is 12 p.m. there. So we set our times according to that. So when it is 12 p.m. there, we'll be having a different time here. We should always remember that we should neither write E nor W with the 180 degree meridian, because both 180 degree W and 180 degree E is the same longitude. It is called the international डेडलाइन, डिड यू अंडरस्टैंड? वी शुड ऑलवेज रिमेंबर दैट वी शुड नीदर राइट ई नॉर डब्ल्यू विद द 180 डिग्री मेरिडियन, बिकॉज बोथ 180 डिग्री वेस्ट एंड 180 डिग्री ईस्ट आर ऑन द सेम लॉन्गिट्यूड एंड दे इट इज कॉल्ड द इंटरनेशनल डेट लाइन. सो वी डोंट हैव टू राइट एनीथिंग, दैट इज सेम. इंपॉर्टेंट प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ द लॉन्गिट्यूड्स, द लॉन्गिट्यूड्स आर सेमी सर्कल्स दैट मीट एट टू पोल्स, हाफ सर्कल्स द मीटिंग एट टू पोल्स टॉप एंड बॉटम. The longitudes are the farthest apart at the equator and gradually the gap between them decreases as we move towards the poles where the longitudes meet. If you are traveling like this full round from the top, so coming to that pole gradually is going to take time, isn't it? The gap between them decreases when you are going towards the pole. So that side one longitude is coming, you are going towards the pole, you are meeting. And one from this side, from the bottom side you are going. So when you are traveling from two sides, both the parts are getting connected. All the lines of longitude are the same length as they extend from the north pole to south pole. Grid and time. The latitudes and longitude crisscross each other and form a network of lines called a grid. The point at which a latitude and longitude meet, that is the intersection, helps us to locate a place. You will see on your GPS, when you look for a map, you will see all squares. Grid. The longitude from the top is coming and the latitudes from the round side, from this side they are going. So they are connecting at one place and that is the forming grids. They are forming small squares. So that joining point, this is the latitude and this is the longitude and this is the latitude. So this point where they are joining is called the grid. This corner is called the grid. That is a point where you can locate what degree, what point it is. How many grids are there? From 0 degree till that place, how many grids are there? So that counting has to be done. As you go forward, you will come to know. The point at which a latitude and longitude meet, that is the intersection, helps us to locate a place. Longitude help us to calculate the time of a place. We know that the earth takes about 24 hours or 1440 minutes to complete one rotation. In other words, the earth takes 4 minutes, 1440 divided by 360 means one circle, 360 degree, to rotate 1 degree. So take out 1 degree, you have to divide it by 360, 140, what are the, how many minutes it takes for one rotation. That is the time difference between two consecutive meridians is 4 minutes. So there is always difference between one grid to one another is 4 minutes. The moment you cross to the east, the international date line or 180 degree longitude, you gain or add a day, and if you cross to the west, you lose or subtract a day. If we go towards the east, from our Indian side, if we go towards the east, we have to add few hours to it. That means they are before us. But if someone is at the west side, we subtract, they are lower than us from our Greenwich time. Because we are calculate the time with the Greenwich time. Okay, these examples I am going to give you. The line is not a straight one and has been drawn in an irregular manner so as to avoid cutting through the land area. So these lines have been made in such a way so that, imaginary lines, so that they don't cut through the area, so that you don't able to know, like it does not spoil the information of the map or the globe. So longitudes help in calculating a time of a place. So we are going to do that. I am going to meet you in the next video. We are done with this chapter. I'll just come back just now.